Onivia, League of Legends highlights, powered by ArcaneBet.com. Bet live on esports.
Definitely have their eyes set on trying to shut Lodic and Edward down.
And despite showing, you know, some different styles, D-Rex were willing to play pretty quick, but Gambit, a last-minute swap to Zoe. So far, but PK's got a lot of minions to farm as this wave crashes in. He's going to get some trading down. Looks like MTC with the Predator pop. He is going to look for this gank here. Maybe a little too far forward here for Staios. Has the flash. Gonna have to use it, but a great follow flash from Empty and just cleans up first blood. Now Kira is gonna flash in, pops the paddle star, but PK flashes out of the way. Flash picked up by Kira, looking to dive in onto Empty.
Does have the push. They end up punishing him for it, and Empty, great use of the flash, expecting Stasius to throw it out, and now Gambit looking for something in return.
Yep, Kira looking. He's gonna try and find a good dodge there from PK, but he is gonna die to Diamond procs. Nice answer there from Gambit.
So Diamond walks around behind the tower alongside
Kira. Some potion charges.
And heal really coming up big right there. Empty now looking for a gank in mid.
Coming back at it, doesn't have the flash, but Kira, oh no, portal jump, gets himself altered, and that's a sitter for Candy to collect.
Remember that Kira used his flash up towards the top side of the map.
Is maybe going to struggle after that trade kill. Ooh. In fact, Diamond's back again. Staios is going to start it up already, burns the ulti, Diamond over the wall as PK with no flash. He's just left out to dry. He's going to fight as best he can, sap the magic where he can. A great set of dodges, but not enough as Empty.
Here comes Empty.
He's going to try and trade back in. There's the ulti, alley-oop towards the turret, not quite in range to get the hit, and the chilling smite channels the W, but can't get back
Fire
in.
Is kind of what you would expect, and you're still kind of looking at the poke strength there, but this could be bad.
Edward forced a flash. That's Lodic dead, though. They split up, and that's going to give that first turret as well over to Stitch. 600 gold for Desire.
Then if you're in a losing lane matchup, you can rely on the late game scaling, but Ezreal doesn't have the greatest late game. He doesn't often build towards crit. Kira could be in some trouble.
But oh yeah, that's a really nice Dark Spear! And the ulti enough to kill. Well calculated there by Candy.
And Kira, he was just hanging around. He was like, okay.
Herald maybe thinking D-Rex would be caught in a back timer. But again, Kira looks for Candy. Great bit of damage. Here's Empty. Body slams in the block to follow up. A Koala maybe going to catch him. Damage follow up is there. Empty over the wall with the flash. And Kira is going to go down. The Herald, though, did fall. Who is going to grab it? Stitch going to try and get them off the buff as he ultis aggressively forward and pulls back the feathers. Doesn't quite grab
it. It's really long back and forth, trying to secure it. And what was the most tense Rift Herald eye fight I think I've ever seen?
I don't see that one too often, but at least the Constellation Cloud here for Gambit. Usually his plays is very high. But they haven't gone like crazy mode yet in the games that I've watched. And again, Gambit's coming off. They play back, they land a stun, they go in! And there's a recombo shutdown! Diamond procs falls to Candy.
Another good pick found by G-Rex, and now they can start sieging onto the... They'll obviously go up against the second siege. A, B, or C, and with the way things are going, one of them could be G2, but we'll see later on.
Out from Stitch, flank here from PK. Really nice angle on the ulti, but Diamond Proc, he's going to be the first one. He's going to cut them off. He might save his team. He flashes over his own wall as Staios looks for the re-engage. Stopwatches as Koala takes a big chunk of damage from Kira, but they left a Sion out in the front side, and G-Rex swoop in for that kill as PK diving back in towards the rest of Gambit. Zombie Sion on the cooldown site is going to pop the blast cone and just try and zone Diamond out of this, but he's walked back around. I don't know if G-Rex can really stay. The bubble from Zoe. Koala again, he's trying to keep Kira out of there. He ignites him down. He might get a kill. 1v1 versus the mid lane. He does grab it. Zoe dead. And now G-Rex re-engage. Shut down there for Diamond, but two more kills over to G-Rex.
And G-Rex just keeps finding kill after kill. Gambit will successfully force you flash out from Stasios. G-Rex still unable to find the fight, but here's PK on the flank again.
Another glorious angle here from the Maokai. Kira, maybe the first bit to tie it up. Both mages is going to get locked down. They need the jungler. They're not going to look to take him down. Diamond will fall to Stitch as Staios boosted into the team by the Gragas ulti. Candy dominating as Staios goes down again. And G-Rex with the jungler picked off might look to chase more. They want another kill. They want Kira. PK finds the lockup. Empty able to grab it. And Baron's on the table. We'll see if they push or go straight to the worm.
G-Rex looking good in their first game.
Has to be careful of Lodic, perhaps. The poke is pretty strong in these situations, but Koala going to come out here as well. Moves the shield back around. It will take a miracle steal here from Lodic, who doesn't even have his ulti. And that combo from Candy demolishes the Gambit AD carry. And G-Rex, they'll get themselves a kill, and they'll get the Baron.
And
a semi-rotating door of teams that come from the LMS and have kind of mixed results. G-Rex are looking to really put their stamp on the World Championship early on. They will take the turret. Khalil Wall doesn't quite cut him off a Diamond, and they'll just dive into the front line again onto Staios. PK pops the watch. goes golden as Koala dives to the backside, trying to find the carries. Charms up one, dances back around as Stayhouse rooted in place. Will be killed by Candy, who now goes godlike, and it's gonna be a mess. A double kill for Syndra, who finally gets picked off by a zombie Scion. But Lodic forced to get away, does buff the arcane shift out of the root there from Maokai. But G-Rex, they're just going to walk it in. They've still got Stitch alive as well.
They have their eyes set on the Nexus and first seed in the group.
Certainly only two turrets and a thrown away from taking this all down. Lodic and Edward fighting for their lives. It's 10 seconds left on the nearest Gambit member, but it's just not going to be enough. G-Rex continue their rampage through the group, and they'll finish atop it in style.
Fantastic stuff from G-Rex. I think you can confidently say that G-Rex is looking good. There were question marks. Will they be able to maintain that consistency? Will Gambit be able to bounce back? But I feel like G-Rex, once again, they drafted a strong 2v2 lane down towards the bot side. They demolished Lodic and Edward. And then we saw glimmers of hope from Diamond Procs kind of matching some of the early aggressive plays that we did see from Empty. To me, it just felt like that Empty was the one coming out on top. And because he got his laners ahead, they then used that lead to shut down Gambit's laners. And so while Diamond Procs was fed, Kira ended up falling massively behind in the laning phase.